There was a dawn radio and Chin Up is the name. Oh, and now they're back with a brand new show. And Morning Daily is its name. Oh,
Morning Daily, oh, Morning Daily, oh, Morning Daily, oh, and now they're Mingletainment.
And now they're Mingletainment.
Crossfire Monday right here on S24. Throughout the day, we'll be taking a look at both sides of the issues, both sides of the stories.
Flip the coin,
whether it's with regards to finance, current affairs, sports. There's no debating, however, that Liverpool certainly kicked
some serious butt. We don't need to flip. No one should even look at that, please.
Arsenal, on the other hand, I've got a lot of debate about.
There's nothing to talk about.
Like, why do you still consider
yourself very brave,
a soccer team?
Because we are brave, win or lose, we will still turn up. We'll be on the pitch, whether we win or we lose, we turn up.
There's no trophies. We were part of it for participation.
All right, let's move on. This is Morning Daily. This is not part of what we're discussing this morning. Like, stop it.
I'll tell you what we are discussing. Yeah. Let's look at the photograph.
Oh, wow. Not the ones I took over the weekends. Trust me, you don't want to see those. No, thank you very much.
Ooh,
let's move on.
Those party pictures. No. No, not those party
pictures. All right.
Pictures. So
in studio right now, we have been joined by a professional photographer. His name is Denise Mubanga Kabwe, and he runs Mubanga Photography. Did I get that right?
Mubanga Media.
Mubanga Media.
Yes.
All right. So good to have you in studio.
Thank you very much. Mm. Great to be here at the Kawalala party.
Indeed.
Yeah. Now, before you copper me, there is a picture that's going around that is causing a lot of debate on social media. Yeah. All right. Mm. And this has to do with a young individual who allegedly is captured with a voter's card and an NRC.
Mm. So we'll be getting into that shortly. Obviously, we need to talk about that as well because you're the expert in studio right now. Yeah. But just tell us, I mean, before we get to all of that, for how long have you been in this industry, photography?
I joined photography some time back in 2015. So
2015,
roughly
okay.
Over 5 years.
Over five years, so okay.
It's been a great journey.
Mm. Yeah. All right, so we had to bring you in so that we get to the bottom of this one because the debate going on, of course, is some people saying, look, those images were doctored, those images were photoshopped. ECZ saying that they are not authentic. Now, they haven't said as to how they feel it is not authentic, as to whether, you know, editing software was used or whether it was just an actual shoot. According to your expert opinion, Mr. Mubanga,
how do you tell if a picture is authentic or not?
Okay, so before we go into the whole technical nitty-gritties, the first thing as a person, every time you look at a photo, you should be able to tell, it's okay, how are the shadows falling? Mm. How is the light in this photograph?
Okay.
So when you look at this photograph, you are able to tell to say this shadow on this little boy as he's being captured, is that you get to see it on his left hand side. So you get to see that, you get to see how the light is as well affecting the chair. So it shows that this is real. Those aren't anything photoshopped. So there was an older person and then they just decided to put in a little boy there.
Right.
So these aren't all that. However, on the technical side, you can be able to go on Google. So you say Google Images.
Okay.
So you take this exact photo and then you upload it on Google Images. So Google Images will be able to show you where this photo comes from. So like, for example, I had to do this. So it showed that somebody posted it on Twitter.
Okay.
So that's where it shows.
The background didn't change. The height didn't change.
No, it's the same thing which somebody had posted on Twitter. Hmm. However, with Facebook, all these social media platforms, is that every time you upload a photograph, information is lost on the photograph.
Okay.
So on our phones, every time you take a photograph, if your location is on or your GPS, it will be able to show where exactly you took that photograph, at what type, at what conditions, time of day. Hmm. So the photograph will have that. However, every time it goes online on social media, all that information
is lost. Those details get further and
further away. So with this one, all we know is that it was taken on a phone. Somebody used a phone to take this photograph. I used photoforensics to be able to see if this image was doctored in any way.
It's not like they got cheese nose and then they put my forehead and nothing like that.
Nothing like that was done. Okay. So this is an actual real photograph. Mm. Nothing staged, nothing doctored. This, somebody took this photograph. They took their time, taught the boy what to do, and they took it.
Yeah. Now, we've just had the executive director of the Zitukude Consortium, Mr. Nicholas Perry, talk about the fact that further investigation would have to be done, all right? That it is the responsibility of government to go out there, not just end on a story like this and just say, look, this is not an authentic situation.
But listen, now if you're going to say that, because, I mean, let's look at this institution, ECZ.
Yeah, you need to
and
find out why someone set
this up.
And
if the head is going to come out and say, that picture is not authentic.
So
don't you
why
think?
Take it
are you trying
in the
to
first
tell
place?
Me he did not involve the experts as well? We have an expert in studio right now.
No, no, that's not the point I'm making. The point I'm making is this, okay? He has involved the experts. We've involved the experts. My question is, what next? You have to find out why an individual would actually go to this extent. What was the purpose?
And which center this was.
Which center this was, what they were trying to pull off, because ECZ saying that individual's not in the system. So they talked about the lack of authentication being that the alleged cards that young individuals holding are not real. Mm-hmm. They're not in the system. Mm-hmm. All right. So as much as it may have been staged, why? I think that there's real need to get to the bottom of that one. Make sure you actually give us your comments and contributions on Mingletainment. You can download the Mingletainment app. We have from Mubanga Media, Mr. Mubanga himself joining us right here in studio. We're taking a look at going straight to the source of this, because S24 needs to do that. And when it comes to Crossfire Monday, this has been a serious debate in the media.
Yeah, so now coming to your industry, what are some of the challenges that you're facing? Or is it all smooth? You know, like some of these images that you take look, you know, they're so smooth, no challenges at all. Like, you know, everything is going well. What are some of the challenges that you're facing?
Especially when it comes to fake news.
Yeah.
I know there's a lot of doctored images that are coming out now.
I think for 2021, we should expect more of that. We should expect doctored crowds showing that there were a lot of people.
Doctors.
They were there. They were there at our rally. I tell you.
Doctored crowds.
They were there, for real. Even though they had Biden posters. That was for Kawalala Party. It was a real crowd.
you will see a lot of that. And here in Zambia, we don't appreciate, and I think on the more fashion sense, beauty type of photography, most people really don't embrace how they look.
Yep.
Want something
we need filters, come
they
on.
They need filters, they need tummies trimmed or...
Six-pack for chi.
So all that. So I think the major challenge has been lack of education and just understanding the art of photography.
Okay. Mm.
Everybody thinks and looks at it as just, I'm a copa che my picture.
Copa me.
So without understanding what's the whole process. Because for me to take a photograph, I have to, first of all, think.
Mm.
I just don't shoot and just wake up and so I'm taking a picture, so what's the reason why am I taking that photograph?
Yeah,
that's what even brings us to this image we're discussing today. Say, what's the reason? What are you trying to communicate? So each and every photograph has to communicate.
It should have a message.
Photography is you're documenting history. You're telling what is. You're showing the people to say, okay, this actually happened.
So what of this trend that we've been talking about from the Minister of Guidance and Religious Affairs, this trend of having too much sexy all over social media? I mean, I'm sure you've seen
in
this.
Advertising.
In advertising. I was talking about some of these apps, Instagram. Sometimes I actually feel guilty. Just don't ask me why I have them as friends in the first place. But it's a growing trend. And I must say, especially among the ladies, you can innocently accept a friend request. And next thing you know, majority of her images are half nude, with a Bible verse, by the way. Don't forget the Bible verse. So I'm not even sure what that is supposed to translate.
Really?
But what do you make of that growing trend where people actually feel as though, now it's just time to expose my body anyhow?
Sexy sells.
What does?
So
But what are they trying to sell? I mean,
it's influence. People are now dealing with numbers. With this online platform, the numbers speak for you. If you have the correct numbers, you make the most money. So if you have those numbers, so now you have people having beautiful photo shoots at beautiful locations just to sell and give us this perception of life. Remember, a photograph is telling a story.
Right.
For toilet paper? It's okay. Like how? We've seen quite a number. Like, so what are you doing? Why should you be nude?
We've got Dennis
for toilet paper. Kabwe. Oh, go commando all out.
Like, for toilet paper.
For toilet paper.
All right. We've got to wrap it up there. Dennis Mubanga Kabwe from Mubanga Media. Thank you so much for your expert opinion as we get down to the source of this story. Thanks
yeah,
so
and
much.
Your social media presence, in case we want to find you there.
Yes. So Facebook is Mubanga, Instagram Mubanga0318, LinkedIn Mubanga.
Great.
And he's got his clothes on and all the pictures. Well done.
Morning Daily with Chi and Hope. The quintessential start to your day.